Welcome to Instrukart Holdings, a worldwide instrument partner. Now we are having a Subzero SZ-7529 touch sensitive temperature controller. This touch sensitive temperature controller are the next generation of Subzero controllers, which has a high IP ratings and an excellent iconic display. The temperature controllers are specially designed for refrigeration applications and for safety of compressors. This SZ-7529T is specially designed for defrost applications with a measuring range of minus 45 to 99 degrees Celsius. And this can operate under an operating temperature of 0 to 60 degrees Celsius and an operating humidity of 20% RH to 85% RH. And this temperature controller has some process connections with few terminals. These 1 and 2 terminals are for probe to connect NTC probe. This is the NTC sensor connected to sense the temperature between the range of minus 45 to 99 degrees Celsius with a resolution of plus or minus 1 degree Celsius and with the same accuracy of plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. And 3 and 5 terminals are for the input power supply of 230 volts AC. And these are the terminals to connect the compressor output. And you can see here it has a display of 29 by 71 mm with a flush panel mounting. And this temperature controller has a polycarbonate plastic front cover with a gasket. This is the gasket and this is the ABS plastic. And these are the touch sensitive keys provided for various functions. This is the set key. This is to enter into program mode. And this is used as a dual function in order to come back and in order to enter into a defrost cycle. And this is a 7-segment LED display. And this indication is for compressor. You can see it is showing the compressor. And we can set various parameters like starting with the compressor relay set point. In order to set the compressor relay set point, you have to hold the set key for 2 seconds to showing. This is the compressor relay set point temperature set. That is, it is stored the data. Now it is showing the current temperature which is sensed by this NTC probe. And we can also set the higher temperature and lower temperature by entering into program mode. In order to enter the program mode, you have to press this program key, press and hold for 2 seconds. It is showing the parameters. Now it is showing P2 set. P2 is to set the higher temperature limit. This is the higher temperature limit I set. You can increase or decrease. 35 set. This is the current temperature. Now I will check whether it works or not. I am increasing the temperature of the sensor. Now you can see on the display the temperature is increasing. You can see here it is showing the HD display. As it reached the 35 degrees Celsius, which is the maximum set by the user. Until and unless it will reach to the current temperature, it will blink with the HT. And you can see here it is showing the alarm indication. And we can also set for the lower temperature limit. In the same way, if the temperature reaches below the lower temperature limit, it will give the display as LT, same as like here HT it is showing. It will show LT in the lower temperature case. And you can see 35 HT is showing. Now it got the temperature below the higher temperature limit, so that it is not showing the alarm. And in order to get into HS parameter, that is maximum set point limit, to enter into program mode by pressing this program switch P2, P3 is for lower temperature, same as high temperature, but it should not be less than minus 40, as the controller set with the minus 40 degrees Celsius, and higher temperature limit is also below 99 degrees Celsius only set. And HS is to set maximum set point limit set. I set the maximum set point limit for 30 degrees Celsius. So if I set this to 30 degrees Celsius, it will not allow to go above 29 degrees Celsius. And to set a minimum set point limit, LS set, I set to minus 40. Can change. If I set the minimum set point limit to 10 degrees Celsius, it will not allow the set point to go below minus 9 degrees Celsius, that is LS plus 1. And you can also set the differential for the compressor relay on. To set this parameter, to enter into program mode, P2, P3, HS we done, LS we done, P4. I set the differential set point as 2 degrees Celsius. This differential set point is nothing but when the compressor has to restart again. If the compressor has to shut down at 10 degrees Celsius, if I set this differential as 2 degrees Celsius, again the compressor will restart at 10 plus 2, 12 degrees Celsius set. And you can also set the probe calibration in this temperature controller, P5. This parameter is to set probe calibration. This probe calibration is nothing but if the comparison of reading values. If the temperature is showing 30 outside, it is showing 28 in this temperature controller. You have to set it to plus 2 so that it will show 30 degrees after this set. If it is set to 2, outside it is showing 30, it is showing 28, you have to add. Then after it will show the current temperature as 30 degrees Celsius set. And you can also set the time delay. Time delay is nothing but to protect the compressor. Even though the compressor reaches the differential plus set point, if the delay time is not reached, it will not on. And you can set the time delay by entering into program mode. In order to set any parameter, you have to enter into program mode. HS we done, LS, P4, P5 we done for probe calibration, P6 set. I set this time delay for 3 minutes. Though the temperature is reached set point plus differential, until it complete the 3 minutes, it will not start, and it will show the flashing here clock symbol. And OT parameter is nothing but minimum on time for compressor delay. If this parameter is set at 1 minute, though the temperature is achieved before 1 minute, the compressor will remain on as it is set for 1 minute. You can set under OT parameter by pressing program key. P5, P6, OT. This is the OT parameter where we can set the minimum on time for the compressor relay. Set 0, 1, but minimum is 0. Set. And you can also set various parameters like compressor relay status in case of probe failure. We can also set the compressor relay status. Set. Compressor relay status can be set under E1 parameter. If I set it as 0, that is the compressor relay status is off. If I set it as 1, it means that it's showing the compressor relay status on. If it is 2, compressor relay performs a duty cycle for CN. CN is nothing but a compressor relay off time. And off, and CY is nothing but on time, compressor relay on time, for how many minutes it will on. And if it is in 2, you can set various other two parameters like CN and CY. I put it as 2 set. Now you can change the CN and CY. If it is in 0 and 1, you cannot have these parameters. Let us check. If I put in this 0 set, CN is for compressor relay off time. If this parameter is set to 4 minutes, then the compressor relay will be off for 4 minutes while performing the duty cycle. And if I set the compressor relay on time is for 10 minutes, it will be on for 10 minutes while performing the duty cycle. CN, CY. CY is for on during the probe failure. And you can also set the parameter for that to set the duration for the defrost cycle. Defrost cycle is nothing but a melting of ice. I will show you with the parallel setting arrangement. This is the most important parameter of this temperature controller, P7. As this P7 is mostly used in the refrigeration applications, and this is set for both manual and auto defrost, and it is especially for how much time the defrost will last. And this parameter is set to 30 minutes, and the defrost frequency, which I will tell later, is set to 1 hour. Then 1 hour after power is supplied to the controller, the defrost will take place for 30 minutes, which is the parameter is set here. If I set this parameter to 29 minutes, it will run for 29 minutes. And frequency P8, this parameter is used to set the frequency of the defrost cycle. Frequency is nothing but how many times it has to repeat the cycle. And if I set this frequency as for 1 hour, it will repeat after every 1 hour. You can set for 1 hour to 31 hours is the maximum, and minimum is 1 hour. And can set various parameters like DF parameter is used to select the display while the defrost cycle is in progress. Set, it can give the display 0 and 1. 0 is displayed when the defrost is on. The control temperature will be displayed. I set to 0. So the temperature sensed by this sensor is showing. If I set that to 1, if I set this to 1, it will show DF on the display. It will show display as DF, and can set parameters like display of temperature. This is nothing but DD. DD is set to delay the display of the temperature by setting a value. If the temperature is increasing gradually, that is the temperature is increasing gradually, you can set the time for how much for every reading. If you set this value to 5 seconds, if this set this value to 1, it will show the for every 5 seconds the temperature will increase. And if it is set to 2, for every 10 seconds it will show you the display by increasing the temperature. and same manner, and minimum is 0 and it can set the maximum up to 36, and 0 is minimum, and other parameters like AD is to set the time delay at power on for alarm indication. For if the temperature is getting higher than the higher temperature limit, it will show you the HT. If it is lower the lower temperature limit, it will show you the LT as explained you at the starting of the video. And PA parameter, coming to PA parameter is to change the password. If for any security purpose you can use this parameter. If the password is kept to other than 0, the user has to enter the correct password. And if the password is 0, user can directly access the program mode. And this is minimum is -99 and a maximum of 99 you can set. And I set the DF parameter to 1 degree 1, so that it will show the DF. Now it is showing the 33. You can keep the password for safety purpose, and you can also lock the keypad by entering into the parameter. PA is to change the password, is to set the password, and LP is to lock the keypad. Set. If it is 0, the keypad is unlocked. If it is showing the 1, you can set locked. 1 set. And you can also restore the default settings of the controller by entering into FS parameter, by setting FS parameter. This is the FS parameter where you can disable or define the value or for user values. Set. If it is 0, the FS is disabled. If it is 1, is as per default value. If it is 2, the user defined values are restored. And you can also end the program by entering into the parameter, last parameter EP. EP is to end the program. Set. And you can see here, this is to indicates that compressor is on or off. And you can see before it is showing the clock symbol here, that is the time delay is on or off. You can see alarm, and here is one LO, that is for defrost. And this product comes with a pair of fasteners. The carrying case, and with the instruction manual for user purpose. And for more details and direct purchase of the same product and similar products, you can visit our website www.instrukart.com. Thanks for watching.